Well, first of all, congratulations to each of you for the nomination and for opportunity to be here today. In preparation, I'd be shocked if you haven't been advised that when it comes to be Senator Padilla's turn, here's a question to anticipate. Diversity is a beautiful thing. It's I think one of the biggest strengths of our nation, not just across the board, not just in communities, not just in government, but in particular the federal judiciary. I know my colleague, Senator Herosa, asked a general question about diversity. I always ask about diversity because diversity is important, not just in terms of who sits on the federal bench, right? The diversity of life experience, the diversity of professional experience ought to be part of the process and considered not just for more inclusive and reflective outcomes, but for public confidence in the federal judiciary and its decisions. All that being said, what I tend to ask nominees is, what would you do if you're fortunate enough to be confirmed to advance diversity in your courtroom, if you agree with my value statement, and if you disagree, I'd love to hear it. And not just broadly with support staff and whatnot, but particularly when it comes to law clerks. I think most of you may have a specific example or experience where a quality clerkship experience can really help a career at the outset, whether you pursue public service, whether you pursue private practice, that clerkship opportunity can be pivotal. So what can we do to open the door to that experience for a more diverse group of young law students and law clerks than we have historically? And we'll start with Mr. Casaway.
Senator, I agree with your value statement. And with respect to the work on the court, it's absolutely important to bring diversity and diverse experiences from all backgrounds, not to staff. That's important, but law clerks, over the 16 years that I've served on the bench, I've worked hard to ensure that I have a diverse group of law clerks that have worked with me throughout all of these years. But we have to go further than that. It has to be externs, people from law school, students, and then reaching out into the community to high school and middle school to make sure that people are thinking about law school, not just at the last minute, but their entire lives.
Thank you.
Senator, I agree that diversity is important. Over the last 5 years as a federal magistrate judge, I have hired law clerks from different geographic backgrounds, religions, genders, of course, law schools, and national origin and race. But you know, all those experiences, I believe, are important to enrich and give different perspectives on backgrounds. And so it is something that I'll continue to do with the law clerks that I hire.
I started my legal career as a law clerk to a magistrate judge, and I know the value that clerkship provided to me and the doors that it opened. When I look to hire not only law clerks, but interns and externs that help and assist in my chambers, I do look at not only their personal diversity, but their professional diversity. And that is important to me when I make that decision on who to hire.
Thank you, Senator. I agree with the comments of my colleagues. I think diversity is very important. I think it helps to, when you draw more people into our institutions, particularly institutions like the judicial system, I think that helps to affirm the confidence that the community must have in our institutions. I would also just say, I think academic diversity is important as well. I came from a state law school, and you know, these positions, they are great and they are stocked with a lot of people from the top schools, but I think there's a lot of talent within our state schools. And so if I were fortunate enough to be confirmed for this position, I would have an eye towards that as well.
Thank you, Senator. I don't think I could say better than my fellow nominees. I agree that diversity is important in its broadest sense. And I also agree that legal clerkships at the beginning, especially really at any point in a nominee's career, are incredibly important. They were certainly important experiences for me. And I would be carefully trying to pick the best people for those positions, recognizing their importance.
Thank you very much. Mr. Chair, before I close, I just want to clarify that there's still an opportunity. The deadline for letters for the record, letters of support for these nominees is still open.
Yes.
So there's still time for Mr. Semper's mom to weigh in here, if necessary.
I'll do some lobbying. Thank you.